This video will show you how to use the FX991EX scientific calculator to convert between different forms of numbers. So if you get a solution that's a decimal but you want to see its rational number or fraction form, or if you have a standard form and you want to change it to its decimal equivalent, mixed number to its improper, we're going to walk through that with you on this calculator. The nice thing about Casios is if you're familiar with one model, you pretty much can understand and see where the other models have the same buttons, those types of things. We try to keep things very consistent. So just like in the other scientific calculators, we have two buttons we're going to be working with today. So this is the template button. So this is how you enter a rational number or a fraction. Or if you want, you use the shift and this button. So this is right under the option button. You hit the shift and you can enter a mixed number. We'll do a little bit of that as well. When you get a solution or you're trying to convert between different forms of a number, so fraction to decimal, decimal to fraction, mixed number to improper, this button up here above the delete button, so S to D, is how you're going to do those conversions. So if it's just a standard number to a decimal, that's clicking this button. But if you have mixed numbers and you want to see their mixed number equivalent or their improper fraction equivalent, you would hit the shift button first. So let's just go through a couple of these just to show you how easy it is to do these conversions. So I'm going to be in the calculate menu, so I'm just going to hit equal to enter that. And let's just do a simple division problem. So 2 divided by 5. And when I hit equals, I get the solution as a rational number or fraction. Well, maybe I want to see the decimal equivalent. All I have to do is hit this button above the delete, the standard to decimal, and it will show me the decimal equivalent. So that's very easy to do. And if I want to go back to the standard, I click that button again. So if you have a standard to decimal, all you're doing is clicking this button, S to D, and going back with between the different values. Let's say you are working with a improper fraction. So let's actually use this template to enter an improper fraction. So let's do 22, and I'm going to use my template button, and let's put it over 8, and I'm going to hit equals, and I get the simplified version of this improper fraction. So this is also still an improper fraction. Well, let's say I want to see what that is as a decimal equivalent. So I'm going to hit the standard to decimal button. So that always changes what version I have. So standard to decimal, or if I have the decimal, it'll change it back to standard. So we're going to see that that's equivalent to 2.75, 2 and 75 tenths. And if I hit it again, it would go back to that form. Well, let's say I now want to actually see, I understand that this is a improper fraction, and I want to see the mixed number version. And we know it's going to be two wholes, but what's 75 tenths look like as a fraction? So this is where, if you look above the S to D button, it will show you that you can go from improper to mixed number. So we need shift first. Now hit the S to D button, and now it's going to change it to its equivalent mixed number version. And again, if I hit standard to decimal, it goes back to decimal, it goes back to improper, and then shift standard to decimal gives me the mixed number. So we can see all three equivalent forms of that number very quickly by using these different values. You can also enter, let's say, a mixed number. So let's click shift mixed number, and let's say I'm being asked to simplify this, get the decimal equivalent, so let's just and hit equals. So it's going to take my mixed number, convert it to its improper version. If I hit the standard to decimal button, it shows me the decimal equivalent. And now I could even do shift standard to decimal, and I could see the simplified version, which happened to be the one that I was given. So very quickly, very easily, with those two different buttons and the shift, sometimes you can convert between different values, different forms of a number, decimal form, fraction form, mixed number form, and improper fraction.